Hello children, the food we eat and the clothes we wear and also the physical features change depending on the environment. Just as human beings adapt themselves to the changing environment and the living condition, animals also adapt themselves to the changing environment so as to survive. You might have heard about the dinosaur which became extinct. Why they become extinct? Because they were not able to adapt themselves to the changing climatic condition. Hence, they died. So it is very important for an animal to adapt themselves to a certain habitat where they live. Animals have special features and behavioral factors that adapt themselves to a particular environment so as to survive and live happily. So today we are going to study about adaptation in animals. Our topic is adaptation in animals. Now, let's learn about the definition of adaptation. Adaptation are characteristics that bird and animal have developed over the years which help them to survive in their environment or habitat. Adaptation in animals can be of three types: adaptation for habitat, adaptation for food, and adaptation for protection. They adapt themselves for living in certain environment, and they are classified into five types. They are terrestrial, aquatic, animals that live both on land and water. They are called amphibian, arboreal animal, and aerial animal. That means the animal that fly. Adaptation for food can be of four types. They are herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, and parasites. Adaptation for protection. Certain animals adapt themselves so as to be saved from the predators. So they adapt certain body features so as to be protected from the animals they eat them. So now let's learn about the terrestrial animal. The animals that live on land are called terrestrial animal. They breathe with the help of lungs. They have sharp teeth and claws so as to catch its prey. They have strong legs to walk and run on the ground so as to catch its prey and also to escape from enemies. They have a strong senses and well-developed senses to feel the changes that happens in the surrounding and also to look for food. It also helps them to protect them from the enemies. These type of animals, land animals, are found in different parts which differ with the climate. And they are polar region, desert, and plains. You can see over here the terrestrial animals. Now let's learn about the animals that are found in polar region. Polar region are generally cold and are covered with snow. The animals that are found over there are penguins, seal, reindeer, and polar bear. They have a thick layer of fat inside the skin, and these are called blubbers. This can be found in penguins and seal. Seal also has a streamlined body, and the hind limbs are modified into flippers so that they can swim inside the water. Also, penguins generally huddle up together so as to escape the extreme cold. They have thick fur on their body so as to escape from the severe cold. You can see the reindeer and the polar bear over here. They have extreme fur on the body so as to escape the cold. The polar bear become inactive during the winter. That is, they go to sleep in the winter period so as to escape the extreme cold, and this process is called hibernation. Hibernation can also be seen in some land animals like frog, lizard, snakes. They hide in certain holes or caves and in order to escape the winter season. they store food or they consume food in the generally in the summer season, which they use in the winter season. So the short sleep during the winter is called the hibernation. Now let's learn about the animals that are found in desert. And the desert are places which are very hot during the day and cold during the night. So the animals that are found over there are camels. Camels have certain features to adapt themselves to the environment, that is the desert where they live in. They have very thick skin so as to protect themselves from the hot sun. And also the cold during the night. They store fat in their humps, and they can use this fat for many days when they don't get food and water. They close their nostrils so as to prevent the sand from getting inside. They have very wide feet so as to prevent them from sinking on the sand when they generally walk on the sand. They are called the sheep of the desert, as you all know. So generally, men, human being use these camels for transport also. So they have to walk on the sand. They have long eyelashes so that the sand will not get inside their eyes. So this type of adaptation is found in camels that live on sand. And they can go through very little water and food. Let's learn about the animals that are found in water. The animals that are found in water are called aquatic animals. Aqua means water. So inside the water, the oxygen are dissolved inside the water. So they generally breathe through the help of gills. You may have found the gills that are present in the fishes. The movement inside the water is with the help of fins and flippers. Fins can be found in the fishes, and flippers are generally seen in turtles. They have a hard cover that cover their body so as to protect them. The scales that are present in fish and the hard shells are present in crabs. The dolphins and whales generally breathe with the help of lungs. So they come to the surface of the water to breathe in air. This type of adaptation are found in fish, dolphin, crab, whale, starfish. Let's learn about amphibians. Amphibians are animals. They are adapted in such a way that they live both on land and water. They have strong long back legs so that they can move on land, and generally they hop on the land. You might have seen the frog and the toad. They move on the land by hopping. They have webbed feet. That means the toes and the feet are connected by the skin so that they can swim inside water. On land, when they live on land, they respire through lungs, and when inside water, they breathe in through the moist skin. This type of adaptations are generally found in frog and toad. Frog and toad also have a streamlined body so that they can swim inside water. You can see the examples over here. Now let's learn about arboreal animals. Arboreal animals are those that generally live on trees. Example, monkeys and squirrel. You might have seen monkey. They are having sharp claws, strong arms and strong legs so that they will hold the branches firmly and they can jump from one tree to another. They generally have a very strong tail so that they can grasp the branches firmly and they will not fall. The tail generally act as a fifth limb. You know, the monkeys can jump up to 30 feet and they can move from one tree to another. So these are the adaptation of arboreal animals, that are the animals that live on trees. Now let's learn about aerial animals. Aerial animals are those which can fly in the air. Example, birds, bats, butterfly. As you can see in the picture, they don't have four limbs. Instead of four limbs, are modified to have wings, which help them to fly in air. They have feathers that are covered throughout the body, which help them to keep the body warm. They have hollow bones and light skulls to make them light when they fly in the air. They have boat-shaped body so that they can easily fly and cut through the air. They have air spaces inside them so that they can use lot of air and they can produce energy while they are flying. So these type of adaptation are generally found in birds, bats. So today we have all learned about the different types of habitats the animals gone through to survive in different habitats, means how they can survive in the cold, extreme cold climate, in water, in air, and in the desert areas. So in the next video, we will learn about the adaptation for food and adaptation for protection. Thank you.